Dr. Richard Mugahe, the Assistant Commissioner in charge of Maternal and Child Health in the Ministry of Health, has attributed the trend to the high rate of school dropout in the two regions.
For us in the health sector, we only see young people getting pregnant. But part of the reason is they need to be educated about their sexuality. Young children, young girls and boys are beginning to get involved in sexual activity at an early age. Education has a role to play. Those who drop out of school are left in the villages doing nothing.
Dr. Nelson Naise, the Chikube District Health Officer, says among other challenges, Bunyoro is also facing high maternal and infant mortality next to Kampala. He has also expressed concern over the low uptake of contraceptives in Chikube District, adding that it currently stands at 25%.
The uptake of family planning in the district of Chikube is about 25%, which is quite low. We think we should be able to do more to ensure that the uptake improves and particularly our adolescents and youth are protected from unnecessary pregnancies.
We all know that pregnancy, we have so many unwanted pregnancies. Actually, it's almost 60% of the pregnancies in Uganda unwanted, unintended. So when someone gets an unintended pregnancy, meaning that a pregnancy by chance, not by choice, it is very dangerous. Some of these pregnancies are the ones which end up in abortion.
Frederick Makumbi, the lecturer of Makerere University School of Public Health that conducted the survey in 2022 under the performance monitoring for action, says some people are still using traditional methods of family planning, which has increased the rate of unintended pregnancies. He has requested the government to come up with an initiative of skilling the youth that have dropped out of school.
How can we tap into the huge population of young people so that they can get skilled and equipped, so they can make developmental projects and improve their health and well-being and get empowered? Yet, so one of the ways is to prevent the dire consequences of unintended pregnancies. If you can prevent that, then they will have time for school, for skilling, for working.
The findings were conducted in 2022 between the months of September and October, and it had three sections that included contraceptive use, partner dynamics, and service delivery points.
We have a challenge with the health workers' knowledge in terms of providing counseling and guidance before they give methods.
Story by Godfrey Momuza for the news.